clear for launch.
The University of Texas has a long history of solar car racing. I'm actually the second of the faculty advisors, and it goes way back to the 1980s. In the very early days, some of the very first solar car races, UT was involved.
Yeah, go ahead, reboot the car.
We've got battery packs, which are charged through photovoltaic cells on the top of the car. The sun charges the battery through these solar cells. So this car is completely off the grid and has little to no impact on the environment at all.
It's a single person vehicle. There's no air conditioning. Systems are designed only to be able to use power available from solar panels, which is only about 1,000 watts, and drive a vehicle at 50 miles an hour.
All right, good drive, everybody. Good drive.
Yeah, excellent work.
Hey, let's put the array right around here.
One of the first things we did was, you know, just to build the chassis. We cut the pipes and had them professionally welded. We made Kevlar boxes, you know. It was just kind of in bits and pieces all over the floor until about a year ago, we started putting it together to get ready for our first race.
And we have to design the car from scratch, so there's not much off-the-shelf parts, for example, the chassis or the body, so I have to design those.
Going from the design phase, we spent a whole summer making the carbon fiber body, made it more efficient. We put a lot of functionality in it, too. We keep adding new things like the touch panel, rear-view camera.
Initially, I did not know anything about electrical engineering, but the team is very good about bringing you up to speed.
Here, we have to unscrew this.
Yeah.
Hey. Hey, bring back the wrenches.
Yeah. Bring back the wrenches?
Wrenches.
We have a telemetry program that can monitor the real-time status of the car remotely from a radio modem.
All the information that's going on in the car is sent through a 900 megahertz data modem to this computer. It's got a range of several miles. We've also got GPS system enabled that can give us kind of a secondary feedback of our direction, our speed. We've got sensors on our tires that wirelessly communicate with our central computer system. So the people in the base station here at the base camp can see everything that's going on with the car. We've got a cruise control system because a lot of these races that we're participating in are endurance races to see how far you can go over several days. Being able to just hit a button and cruise control it is really nice. We like to give everybody that's worked on the car at some point an opportunity to drive it.
Yeah, it's really fun to drive. It's like a go-kart, and it handles really well.
It was very fun to drive, yeah. I just drove it around, actually. I wasn't allowed to go over 30, but I've taken it over 40 as of recently, so I can't wait to see what the top speed's gonna be. It has a good turn radius and everything, at least on like these kind of tracks.
It just demonstrates how much solar power can do with as little as 1 kilowatt of panel and some batteries.
Now try. Better? Is that enough?
That is exactly, that is good.
I've gotten involved in all aspects of the team. I've done mechanical work, electrical work, and outreach work, and that was just a great learning experience for me.
This effort is almost entirely UT undergraduate students.
So it's really a privilege to be able to get involved in this kind of project and being able to personally test the car on the racetrack.
I'm definitely an environmentalist, so there's that aspect, but I'm also really interested in technology, and it's a completely electrical car, so I could like really play around with it and really get into it.
Any student, regardless of major or degree, are welcome to join this organization. If you work hard enough, you could be the architect of the next car.